Candy Crush Saga. It's a fucking waste of my time. I highly advise you not to play this game, no matter how much your friends play it. It's just stupid. Don't click on it. The developers were obviously out of their mind when they set up this game. But since I'm a good person, I decided to do a thorough review of such a shitty game. Let's get this garbage over with. So here's a developer called King. They're the developer that makes a lot of the social games on Facebook and of many shitty aspects, which I'll get to later. King ends up pumping out a lot of shitty games, including Pet Rescue Saga, Papa Pear Saga, Puzzle Saga, Bubble Saga, Pyramid Solitaire Saga, Loop Saga, Bubble Witch Saga, Farm Hero Saga, so many shitty others. Alright, let's do this. So first I'll talk about gameplay. So this game's kind of like Bejeweled, except with more of a theme and more of a story aspect to it. You know, the kind of game where you have to connect at least three in a row, either horizontally or vertically, then those go away and you get points for it. There are a couple different kinds of ways to win a level. On every level, you need to have a certain score to win. Even if you reach the objective, if you don't get a high enough score, you can't advance. You have to play it all over again. Yay, I beat the level. Now, there are four different objectives. One objective is to get these cherries or hazelnuts to the bottom of the screen. Another is to eliminate all this jelly, which is behind the candy, and by eliminating candy on top of it, the jelly goes away. So, this is kind of a bummer in pretty much every situation, because it's so hard to do in a certain number of moves. So, there are a lot of different obstacles, including licorice, chocolate, and elephant shit. One of the things I do like about this game is you can get rewarded for matching up certain combinations, which I think is pretty cool. But, as fun as that may seem, it starts to get boring after a while, and this game just starts to get worse and worse and worse. Now, here's where the game starts getting shitty. They have these power-ups, which you can get to make it easier, that cost real money. 90 cents for them stupid little thing. Also, you can go and buy things in the shop, and it's ridiculously expensive. Let's see, you can get 3 sweet teeth, which are pretty good for, let's see how much. 98 credits I need for $10? Who's gonna waste $10 on this little piece of shit game? You know, this is crap. Also, another thing that pissed me off, it probably took 5 to 6 uncontinuous solid hours of gameplay just to get to level 40. Yeah, pretty tedious. But that's not even the worst part. Like most games, which have a reasonable ending, my friend told me that it goes higher and higher past level 100. You know, that really, really pissed me off. But I don't know, maybe it stops at like 105, a little bit higher. But no. No. I go up 405 levels, I see, and it looks like there's more being made. It just keeps on going. Keeps on going. 350, oh yeah, let's go above these clouds, yep. Let's go 300, 400, 417. Oh, great, great. It looks like there's not even a clear ending. Wonderful. What could be better than wasting hundreds of dollars on a game that doesn't end? Look, there's no ending, and it just fades off. There's no end screen, probably. What the fuck kind of game doesn't end? Time to Candy Crush.
We was crushing all the candy in the Candy Crush saga. The candy kept coming, and so did his punches. He never gave up. He kept punching through. The candy kept coming. The Candy Crush saga. Candy kept coming, and he kept punching. Candy Crush Saga, Candy Crush Saga.
Alright, Candy Crush, I just crushed all that candy. How close am I to done?
Only 424 levels to go.
Also, this game relies super heavy on friends. You gotta ask friends every 10 levels so you can get to the next stage. First, you send them a request, and then they have to log on to Candy Crush, and then send you a request.
It's fucking terrible. I mean, you can spend money on it, you can pay 30 cents to get past this, but who's gonna pay money?
Anyway, you gotta check the boxes of the friends you want to send your request to, and then they have to go on Facebook, and they have to play the game, and then they have to send you the fucking request. It's a waste of time for them and for me. You know, it's already fucking bad enough that you already waste your life on this game. But then, on top of that, you have to have friends that waste their life too on this game. That's bullshit. And maybe it wouldn't be such a bad thing if it was every 50 levels or so. But no, I play a game with over 400 levels. That means I have to do it like 40 times.
But who has that many friends? As you may have noticed, I'm on level 120 or so, and you may think I've had to ask friends to move on to the next stage, what, like 10 times? Well, you know what? I haven't, because I'm smart about this. What I did was I created 3 fake Facebook accounts.
Yep, I'm a genius. Let me introduce you to my 3 different personas.
Hi, I'm Joe Deere. I love helping Parker out. Hi, I'm Toboyolo Carter, and Parker is my bestest friend.
Yo, my name is Sean Ullamon, and I help Parker out in Candy Crush all the time.
Don't you think this is a problem? Not only am I wasting my time playing this game, but I'm also wasting my time being other people in order to help me play this game. Oh, what am I becoming?
A good thing about this game, though, is that you can cheat.
Which is a gold nugget inside this pile of crap. What you do is, when you have 1 life left, you just go to the play screen and just copy the tab over as many times as you want. Which I like to do in Firefox, because it's a lot easier to do than in Firefox and Safari. So, you copy them over. I usually do about 5 tabs so I can get 5 more tries. And you can't do this. Once you copy them over once and play, you can't do it again. But that's alright. Anyway, you can play. Go to this play screen and, you know, just waste as much time as you want. But one of the big problems with this is that it not only hurts my soul, but also hurts my computer. Every time I play, about 5 minutes in, my computer fan will turn on because it gets too hot. And I have a MacBook Air. This is so annoying and probably not good for my computer. So, what I had to end up doing is using a 10-pound barbell under it to use as a heatsink. But this becomes futile when I try to cheat. Having 5 tabs running Candy Crush at the same time makes my computer sound like a freaking semi on the highway. I guess my computer hates this asshole of a game too. Well, since cheating is pretty much impossible, you have to go with the system of lives. You start with 5 lives, and every time you die, you lose a life. And you can gain a life back every 30 minutes. Now, what do you do if you run out of lives? Well, you can buy lives. Let's see how much they cost. $1.10 to get more lives. I'm certainly not paying on this shit game. But it will replenish your 5 lives and give you power-ups if you claim an offer. This means you spend up to 30 minutes trying to get as far as they tell you to in the other game in order to get more lives for Candy Crush. And all the games do this. It's like once the games get you addicted to it, it needs to get you addicted to all the other games in that saga. And there's like 15 of them. It's if I'm not wasting already fucking time already. I have to waste an additional 30 minutes in order to waste another 30 minutes playing the game. It's an endless cycle of bullshit. And then you end up getting addicted to more games by the same developer and wasting exponentially more time. The game is called Candy Crush Saga. Isn't it supposed to be a saga? A long story of heroic achievement? How can I be partaking in more than one saga at a time? It's fucking wasting my life.
How can a game with such good gameplay and so addicting still suck so much?
Candy Crush Saga.
candy ain't the only thing I'm gonna be crushing.
This game's a fucking nightmare.
Candy Crush Saga, more like Computer Smash!